Hi everyone, welcome to the Free Range Diva. A while back I did a video about six healthy swaps. They were six ways that you could easily make changes that would positively impact your health. Well, today I'm going to do six more because it seems like you guys really liked it. So if you want to see my six more healthy swaps, then just keep watching. So first we're going to start with jellies and jams. As you know, we like to keep our sugar low around here and use only natural sugars, and jams and jellies can be packed with sugar, and usually they don't have a lot of nutrition. So instead of using jams and jellies, let me introduce you to fruit butters. This one is an apple butter, but you can find you can find any kind of fruit, all kinds of fruits that are in this butter form. Now, there's no butter in here, but what is in here is organic apples and organic apple juice. That's it. So there's nothing added. They cook it down so that it has a very thick, spreadable consistency like butter. This is delicious on biscuits, toast. It's great to add a little sweet note to your savory dishes. So I use it with like zucchini pancakes, or even on fish that's been seasoned with curry spices, for example, or Asian spices. This is so much healthier for you than regular jellies and jams. And it's a great way to get that little bit of sweetness, but without compromising the amount of sugar that you're getting in your diet. Now, around the holidays, like around fall, look for pumpkin butter. The same idea, so good. But you can find all sorts of fruits that are made into butter. They're basically just cooked down until they're really, really thick. Just make sure that it's only the fruit and there's no sugar added. Next, we're going to be talking about Teflon coated and other nonstick coated pans. So here's the problem. The coating can flake off, it can be ingested, it can off-gas, particularly at higher temperatures, if the pan happens to get too hot. And so there's some controversy about the safety of the PTFE and the PFOE, but here's my point. Why take the chance if you don't have to? There's cast iron, the cooking choice of our grandmothers and great-grandmothers. There's enamel-coated cast iron, stainless steel, ceramic-coated pans, and these pans are really, really popular right now. Brands like Green Pan, the Our Place Always Pan. On Amazon, Tefal has a really high-rated set, and the technology on these ceramic-coated type pans is getting better and better. So all of these choices are non-stick. I threw out my Teflon pans some circa 2000, in the year 2000, around then, and never looked back. You can get a cast iron pan to be non-stick if it's seasoned right. You can get stainless steel to be non-stick. If you're using it in a certain way, you can, and of course, enamel coated, that stuff nothing sticks to it. So switch out your pans. It's really easy. There's a price point for everybody. And like cast iron is dirt cheap. And I promise you, you will reap the rewards of just knowing that you're not getting any of that off-gassing or weird Teflon stuff into your body. You're not breathing it in. It's not in your home. Next up is fabric softeners and dryer sheets. These products are designed to coat your clothes with a chemical that makes them feel softer. At least that's the idea. They often leave behind fragrances after the clothes have dried so that you can still smell them for days and days and days. Here's the problem. Both of these products contain carcinogens like benzyl acetate and limonene. They contain respiratory irritants like benzyl alcohol, ethanol, linked to central nervous system disorders, and chloroform, great, a neurotoxin and carcinogen. And these are just a few of the chemicals that make up these products. So when you're inhaling that fresh scent, Think about what that's doing to your respiratory system. Dryer sheets release their toxins into the air when they're being heated up, posing a risk, a respiratory health risk to those indoors as well as outdoors. So, a little story time. When I was in graduate school, I was on a tight budget, and one of the things that had to go was fabric softeners. So I started doing my laundry without them. After about 2 weeks, I noticed that my clothes felt different. They didn't have that sticky, kind of slimy, chemically residue. They felt like cotton, and so I never went back. To this day, I use a very mild, I use Ecos unscented detergent, and that's it. I don't need my clothes to smell like anything other than the natural smell of the fabric, whatever that is, or basically nothing. If, however, you are a little bit skeptical about giving up your fabric softeners, I have a couple of swaps. One is you can put some distilled white vinegar in the rinse water. That will soften your clothes up a little bit. You can use dryer balls. They're really cheap and you can find them on Amazon. If you're someone that likes scents, then get the dryer balls and put your essential, you know, like a few drops of essential oils on there, or you can put a damp washcloth in with your clothes with essential oil dropped on it so that the fragrance will be released when the clothes get warm. As the clothes dry, you're not going to have something that lasts forever and ever and ever. You don't want that. You don't want to be sleeping in a layer of toxic lung irritants every single night. So don't do that anymore. Or you could do, I almost forgot. You can throw in a tennis ball. If you're really, really cheap, you got a tennis ball around, throw that in there. That'll help. But, you know, I'm wearing this top is 100% cotton. It is so soft, it feels like viscous. You can see, hopefully you can see, just how drapey this is and how the material is just, it wrinkles because I suck at ironing, but that's another story. But you don't need, it feels like a beautiful cotton fabric, and that's what you want. All right, moving on. The next two items are going to be plastic, are going to have to do with getting plastic out of your lives. So let's just give an overall word about plastic. If you haven't heard it enough, it's one of those things that I harp on a lot, but hey, it's good to be reminded. This actually came from an article on Harvard Health, you know, Harvard University. Okay, so the chemicals in plastics known as plasticizers have been found to leach out into whatever they may be coming into contact with, particularly when they're heated. So they can leach out into your food, into your beverages, and they've shown to be very, very particularly harmful to people over the long term, like many, many years. BPA and phthalates are two that we hear about the most. They are endocrine disruptors, they're carcinogens, but there are many, many, many more that are just chemicals, BPS, BPO, whatever, that are just as dangerous and have the same negative health effects. So just because something says BPA free doesn't mean that it doesn't have a lot of plasticizers in them that can still leach out. They also have estrogenic activity. So for those of us at postmenopausal or even premenopausal, the kind of estrogen that it causes the body to release is the very negative carcinogenic kind of estrogen. So as I said, the negative effects of these plasticizers is magnified when they're heated. If you are microwaving and if you are storing and microwaving your food in plastic, this is a really easy fix, and it's going to have a huge impact if you throw out your plastic stuff and start storing things in glass. There are so many of these glass food storage. I bet many of you have already converted or in the process of converting. They are cheap. The problem, though, that I have noticed is that most of them come with plastic lids, and these lids do not hold up over time. Especially if you put them in the refrigerator, they will crack, they will break, they will end up looking like this. Totally useless. And I've maybe had this for 2 years, max. So I've been on the hunt for a solution to that, and I've come up with a couple. Yes, you can use things like mason jars. Those are great. Or you can get yourself a set of these silicone lids. Do you think the pink was bright enough? These you can customize to fit any size, and you just kind of stretch them over the top of the lid like this, and they give you an airtight seal. Liquids won't come out, I've tested. You can put these in the freezer, they're not gonna break apart and degrade and things like that. Yeah, so they have everything from the smaller size, that these can go over glasses, you know, like tall drinking glasses, right up to these huge, I don't know how many lids are in this set. But they're a ton. They're a ton of them. So I got these on Amazon. I'll link them below. If you're just starting out, Amazon has these beautiful glass storage sets with bamboo lids and silicone seals. I will link one that's really, really highly rated that I've had my eye on. I just haven't gotten it because we really have no more room to put any more glass storage containers. But they are gorgeous, they're sustainable, they work really well, and so if you're in the market for a few, like a set of four or six or whatever, I will link a really good one below. So the other plastic product that I wanted to bring to your attention is the coffee maker. They have plastic components where you put the filters, and again, hot water coming into contact with that plastic causes the chemicals and plasticizers in it to leach into your beverage of choice. A while back, I did a video about my quest to find a plastic-free coffee maker, and I'll link that. So I don't have to spend too much time on this here, but your choices are stainless steel percolators. Just make sure that they are stainless steel through and through and don't have any aluminum components. There are French presses in glass and stainless steel. And what I ended up settling on was this Chemex pour over coffee maker. Now I know it's a big ask to switch out your coffee maker. Some of them can be a big investment, especially like the K-cup, the kinds with the pods. But a word about those pods. So I managed to find a company that says that they sell with their coffee ecologically friendly pods. This is good, except that they don't tell you how they're, like, what are they made of? How are they ecologically friendly? I have no clue after scouring their website. So some of them say that they're recyclable, but you have to pull the pod apart. You have to pull out the components. I think it has aluminum and paper components and stuff. You have to get rid of that, and then you can recycle the cup itself. Otherwise, your recycler, I guess, won't take it. So as a result, the vast majority of these pods end up in the ocean. And for me, I've never been attracted to it because it just seemed really wasteful to have just these little single serving things that you then throw out. But I know that they have reusable ones. Those are plastic as well. And the components, obviously, again, I'm sure you put water in your coffee maker in a plastic well that then gets heated up and is sent through the plastic cup or reusable, whether it's reusable or not. So again, I know it's a big ask, but you can get single serving pour over ceramic drippers, I believe is what they're called. I'll show you one. I actually ordered one. I'm waiting for it to show up. When it gets here, I'll cut in a shot of it. So here it is. It did come, and it's totally glass, ceramic probably, with three holes in the bottom so that it's easy to drain the coffee through. And it works beautifully. I did it this morning, and you just put it over your cup, put the filter in, add your coffee, and then pour over the hot water. I tend to have my water near boiling, and then you just let it steep until it all steeps out, and when it does, you have a perfectly brewed cup of coffee. It's actually much easier than the Chemex. And this is a great way to kind of dip your toe into this kind of coffee brewing, because this ceramic dripper was only about $7 or $8 on Amazon, and I'll link it below. They give you really good coffee, and they're very simple to use. So maybe if you switched out your expensive coffee maker a couple of times a week and instead used one of the more plastic-free alternatives. At least that's a couple of times a week that you're not getting exposed to BPA and the other plasticizers. And the little drippers are single serving. So it's great if you just want a quick cup of coffee in the morning, just you know, you don't have to make it for anybody else, then you can just slide that in instead of heating up the machine. So just something to think about. I know, you know, that's probably the biggest, this is probably the biggest, it's not really a simple swap, but I had to talk about it because it can have such an impact on your health. I can tell you that once I switched over to no longer using the plastic coffee maker thing, I lost like 2 inches around my middle, around my tummy. I'm just saying. And so the last thing is really, really an easy one. if you are someone, my mother loves her Lysol and her Glade air fresheners, all these things, you know, like those things that you spray in the air, and they're bad for you. You're again, lung irritants, the same issues that we've talked about. So instead, you can get something like this, which is essential oils and water, basically. This is Mrs. Meyer's room freshener. Especially if you like those really strong, like Glade type of scents, this stuff drives me out of the room. It's that strong. I have a low tolerance for fragrance, as you may have figured out. But my mother will use this because it definitely, you spray it in the bathroom and you can smell it all over the house. So this is a good alternative if you like that, if you like those stronger type fragrances. You can also, if you like a lighter fragrance like I do, just get your own atomizer and spray it instead. And that way you can customize, you know, use essential oils and water, and you can then customize how much of that you want to, you know, how strong you want it. You know that potpourri stuff? Forget that. Just grab a bottle of your essential oil and, you know, put a few drops in the toilet before you go. And then it does the exact same thing. Then go and flush it, and it does the exact same thing. I promise you, you don't smell anything. Now I'm going to leave it at that. Okay, everybody, I thank you for watching, especially if you got this far. If you did and you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you really enjoyed it and you want to see more, then please subscribe. I put out videos every Friday. They're on these kinds of topics, living healthier and you know, inner beauty and just vibrant, good health. Yeah, I'd love it if you joined me. So hit the subscription button, the notification bell, blah, blah, blah. All right, everyone, again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in a week. And until I see you in my next video, I'm wishing you a wonderful day, a wonderful week. Take good care of yourselves, and I will talk to you again very, very soon. Bye.